Shalom, and welcome to our special Talmud Torah Connected Kulam series, in which we are focusing this Aseres Yemei Tshuva on the centrality of Torah learning in our lives. To that end, we are sharing with you 10 videos for the 10 chapters of the Rambam's Hilchos Tshuva. Today, we begin with Perek Aleph, the first chapter, and the power of words. In the first chapter of Hilchos Tshuva, the Rambam delineates two modes of reconnecting to Hashem. One is called kapara, atonement. That was accomplished primarily in the Beis HaMikdash through a karban, a sacrifice. The other is tshuva, the process of return and renewing our relationship with Hashem. What's interesting is that the Rambam, in this perek, clarifies for us that both kapara and tshuva require words. In the context of kapara, it's the vidui, it's the confession that takes place, for example, when the Kohen Gadol recites its confession on the karban, on the sacrifice, on the par, or the sire, the cow, or the goat. When it comes to tshuva, it's the vidui, it's the confession, which is part of the process of renewing our souls, reconnecting to Hashem, and for example, we say, al chet, or ashamnu. Why is this so important? So the Rambam perhaps is underscoring for us that even though we may have remorse, we may have charata, we may want to return to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, but those thoughts, they're ethereal, they are abstract. It's only when we put our thoughts into words that they become concrete and they become real. This process of renewing ourselves, this requires that it be real to us. And in order for that to happen, we must have words. And therefore the Rambam says, today we don't have kapara, we don't have a karban, we have tshuva. And so to do tshuva, says the Rambam, chayav lehisvados lefnei hakel baruch hu. We need to make it real to ourselves by saying those words. And when we do that, we can truly face who we are and assess ourselves in order to repair and renew our relationship with Hashem, with ourselves, and with others.